Hi everyone. I know Halloween is over, but this is the first chance I've had to upload this video, and I just got a real quick process showing you how I put it together. It's made out of cardboard and I covered it with gesso. I used some crushed olive to do the stenciling on the brick, and throughout the rest of the video I used walnut stained, vintage photo, and a lot of spiced marmalade. I'm just creating the moon effects here, and I rubbed a little bit over that moon because it was a little too bright and I wanted to have a scary look to it. The stencils I used are from Crafter's Workshop, and I use alcohol to take off that stays-on ink. And right here I'm just adding some branches, and then I'm adding some spiced marmalade and vintage photo to kind of bring down some of that color, like a moonbeam shining through. And I use the barn door distress ink here to color the bricks, and then I mix some walnut stain and black soot to tone down that red. This is a white acrylic paint just for the inside of the bricks. So I mix a little black and white so I can highlight the branches a little. These leaves were cut out from my Sizzix, and I just added some spice marmalade and vintage photo on some, and then spice marmalade and walnut stain on the other to kind of give it a variegated look. And I use a stylus pen there to emboss the veins in the leaves, and then I kind of pinch the leaves up a little bit and bend them and curl them so they won't just lie flat. And I'm showing you this package. The stamps came in. There's no name on. I don't know where I got them, but it's just a little Halloween stamp package. I stamped the cat and the bats and the skull, and I didn't care much for the bats. I'm going to freehand cut here. And the nice thing about doing your own projects like this, you can make things up as you go. So I made some funky looking bats. Anyway, I use them and I emboss on them a little bit. These flowers are from Recollections, and I pulled out a few, wet them down and scrunched them up real good and dried them and opened them up and put them together, and I run them through that black soot and to give it the look that they're dying or wilted or rotting. And that's what I use for the flowers. There's a little cheesecloth. I cut the little fence out with my Silhouette and put that Eileen's glue and scorched it over a flame. And then the little skull I embossed with some clear emboss so it would be a little shiny. And I'm using a little bit of moss here. And in a little while you're going to see me struggling with the glue strings. I had Fuzzy cut those little witches out of some fabric that I bought at Walmart. I guess it was a couple of years ago. And they're kind of like felt, and they have a little bit of glitter on them. So that's what I was using for the witches. Okay, now the glue strings, I just get entrapped in them. Yikes. Okay, and this is where the video stops, and here's the finished photos. I put little stickles in the sky for stars, and yeah, this is the rest of it. So I hope y'all like it, and I hope y'all had a nice Halloween, and take care. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.